3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay.
What is history?
Opposites.
You can read the board. I'm so happy to hear that. No, what is it? What does it mean? Stace.
Change.
Thank you, Stacy. I'm glad to hear someone's paying attention. History is the study of change over time. And what's change? It's this, it's opposites. It's two things that push against each other in opposite directions. So the civil rights movement, okay? It's essentially, it's two opposing mentalities. In the South, the majority believes all men are not created equal. And there's a minority who believes that they are. So that minority struggles, and it fights, and it pushes, till eventually, it becomes the majority. Am I boring you? Huh? Let's give you some examples, okay? Of opposing forces, like, I'm gonna go night and day. What else?
Big and little.
Good. Anything else?
Left and right.
Left and right, very good. Stace?
Me and you.
You and I.
You and I.
Teacher, student, anything else?
Mr. Dunn.
Yeah?
Just wondering if you could count me and Gina's bald-headed sister as opposites.
Oh.
Gina, come on, tell me you're not gonna take that. You got a bald sister? Is your sister bald? Give me something.
May 17th, 1954.
Oh. Mm. Hey, Jenny Crane stuck one down to find out.
And I expect some thought from you. I don't want just dates and facts. I want to know why. I want to know consequences. I want to know what it means.
What am I supposed to teach them? You know what I mean? What am I supposed to teach them?
Right.
That's the point, you know what I mean? Yeah. If you can help one student.
Yeah.
No, if you can change one person, right? If you change
you
one person.
Change them all.
No, it's not the point. The point is if you change one.
I
want to
dance.
Then you can teach them.
You want to dance?
The rest of the village.
What is it?
I want to dance.
I have to dance.
Well, I feel good today. Anyone else feel good? Hmm? I need a volunteer, and I need somebody who feels strong. So what we got here is two opposing forces, Terrence and myself. And we're pushing against each other, and as long as one is stronger, and it looks like it's T, the change is slow and consistent. But once the other side becomes stronger, there's a turning point. Thank you, T. Make sense? Okay. Now, turning points can happen like that. They can be physical, or they can happen on a greater scale. Like a war or something. So why don't you do me a favor and write three examples of historical turning points that we've talked about in class. Okay? In Asia, the idea that things are made of opposites, yin and yang, dates back 3,000 years. Taoism saying change is the only constant. But that just died in the West. It just couldn't be both. It couldn't be black and white. It couldn't be right and wrong. It had to be one or the other. Who am I to say that Aristotle's wrong, right? But that doesn't make any sense. These things need each other. The idea that all God's creations are perfect. Perfect. So just to suggest that a tree is it's crooked and it's straight. It's strong and it's weak is to suggest that God created something imperfect. They do, however, acknowledge it in people. We are sinners, but we can strive to be good. Just not in nature itself, I guess, you know.
In the time when the operation of the machine becomes so odious, makes you so sick at heart, that you can't take part, you can't even passively take part, and you've got to put your bodies upon the gears and upon the wheels, upon the levers, upon all the apparatus, and you've got to make it stop, and you've got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all.
What is this machine that he's talking about? It's keeping us down. What is it?
Like robots and stuff, right?
It could be robots. It could be robots, but let's say it's a metaphor. He's saying this machine is keeping me down. Now, what is that? What keeps us from being free? Miss Dre.
Prisons.
Absolutely. Absolutely, prisons. Okay? Prisons are definitely a part of it. What else?
White.
White is definitely a part of it. The man.
The school.
The school, exactly. The whole education system is part of the machine. What else?
Aren't you the machine then?
Oh, no, you didn't. What'd you say?
Aren't you the machine?
You're saying I'm the machine?
Yeah, you white, you part of the school.
Oh, yeah, I guess you got a point. All right, so I'm part of the machine, but if I'm part of it, so are you. You are too. We all are. And this is the thing, remember? Everything is made of its opposing force. We may be opposed to the machine, but we're still very much a part of it, right? I work for the government, the school, but I'm also very much opposed to a lot of its policies. You guys hate coming to school, right?
Yes.
Holler back if you heard me. You hate it, but you come anyway.
Sometimes.
Exactly. Change moves in spirals, not circles. For example, the sun goes up and then it comes down. But every time that happens, what do you get? You get a new day. You get a new one. When you breathe, you inhale and then you exhale. But every single time that you do that, you're a little bit different than the one before. We're always changing. And it's important to know that there are some changes you can't control, but that there are others you can.
Afternoon.